friends, welcome again. Today we have Arnoud with us. So Arnoud is a colleague simplification officer, and he has some bright ideas, reflection moments on building the right things wrong versus building the wrong things right. Arnoud, please enlighten us, bring us into your world.
Yeah, so basically I had to repeat that sentence a couple of times in my head before I actually understood what it was saying. From my perspective, the best thing would be to build the right things right. That would be the best. Then again, other flavors are possible as well, when we encounter a client situations, that's often not the case yet. So what it depends on is what is wrong, what is right. If you look at building the right thing wrong, then at least you know that what you are building has a high quality and is something that is good for the market. But the way in which you do it is open for a lot of improvement. The other way around, building the wrong thing right says something about the quality of your process in producing it. But at the same time, the thing that comes out of the process is not that good. And that can be not that good in many ways. For instance, what is the impact on the world?
Okay, you say impact to the world, but does it also mean like we had this Standish report being published a while ago where they say, okay, 60% of the features built in software products are either rarely or never used. Do you classify this as well, building the wrong things right, or actually building the wrong things wrong maybe?
Yeah, well, that's a beautiful example, but because when you say that gets me thinking, perhaps that effect is a result of both. So if you are building the wrong things, the features that are never used, of course you're not building the right thing then from a customer perspective. But at the same time, somewhere in your process, things aren't going that well as well, because otherwise you would have been building less features that were not used, or you would build features that are actually used. You would know sooner what a customer wants.
Okay, so why do you conclude? So what would you tell our viewers here? What would help in the process to make sure we build the right things then? Because you now say, okay, if we have unused or rarely used features in the market, it means that most probably also we do it the wrong way. So what is concluding you? Why do you come to this conclusion? What is your experience?
So my experience is that many organizations often have a focus on delivering the stuff they invented that would be very handy for their customers to use, even though in many cases they weren't that sure yet. So what they basically do is they create features because they invented this feature will be helping our customers, satisfying a certain need without gathering feedback in an early stage to find out what customers really want.
Ah, and that's where simplification comes in place again. So feedback in an early stage, meaning we need simple process so that we can get feedback on whatever idea we have in a very rapid pace, correct?
Yeah. I'd say so. And there's many ways to experiment on that, I would say. But I think this also starts with assessing where are you now and what are your main problems, your main things that hurt you as an organization, as a product development department, in order to improve from that point on. So first find out what is hurting you, which could be we create all kinds of features and our customers don't use them, or it could be we create all kinds of features and our customers don't even know if they use them. which is a different problem, but one to tackle perhaps before tackling the other.
This kind of left shifting, as we want to call it, in a process design way. So things that we discover late, we want to bring them more to the left and tackle those things up front, or not really up front, but earlier in the process by means of collaboration, not necessarily by means of adding process and things. But we're drifting off. Now we're at like building the wrong things wrong. You were discussing building the right things wrong and building the wrong things right. Do you have an example from not necessarily software development and wrong features, but an example for building the right things wrong and why this would not be a good situation to be in?
Building the right things wrong. From my own experience, without disclosing too much confidential information, of course, that is about a company that provides a self-service portal to its customers. But in doing so, they create a lot of new functionalities. Those functionalities did not work as intended from the start on. So what basically happened was that a certain part of the website was brought live, and then information given by the customers was not saved in the corresponding database further on in the chain of IT systems. So in this case, there was a huge problem with building the right thing wrongly.
In today's COVID situation, I can tell you as well, like our Belgian government, they might come up with the right methods or the right approach. I don't know, because I'm not a scientist, but they might come up with the right things, but they definitely bring it the wrong way. Just to give an example outside the world. Anyhow, if we now say, okay, building the wrong things right, how can this go wrong? So if we build things the right way, so...
I'm not too sure I understand your question, Jurgen.
So we had building the wrong stuff, building the right stuff wrong, and then building the wrong stuff right. So we had the first one already tackled. So let's zoom in a bit on building the wrong stuff right. So
So then I think then it becomes subjective. I think what is wrong, that will be an ethical question. So if I answer that for myself from my perspective, then I would say that wrong things are things that are not good for our world, not for the planet our children inhabit. So could be many things, could be polluting industry, for instance. If that is extremely efficient and they're getting better and better in producing as fast as they can a lot of harming products, then they probably had a very efficient process, very effective as well when it comes to what their goal was. But in my opinion, that would be a wrong thing to do in a very right way.
So if I listen to you, then you would rather have a very slow, troublesome production line of bullets, for example.
So let's not spend our scarce time in optimizing that kind of workflows.
Then again, I've been in India for work, to be honest, and what I have seen there is, for example, at the airport, I gave my passport to one person, and this person is reading it, giving it to another person, who gives a stamp, who gives it to another person. That's not a very effective process. But to be honest, I like it very much, because it's helping the population to be employed, at least. So they earn a buck of money for me as a visitor, as a traveler in that sense, I would be happy if it was one person checking, stamping, do whatever they need, then give it back to me and off I go. But now it was really passing on to three or four people. For their economical situation, I guess this was the right thing to do. So would you consider this as well as a classification of building the right thing wrong?
Yeah, well, in examples like this, I always feel humble. So who am I to make that assessment? In general, I think the current effect is that it's great that people are employed, are able to take care of their family, so on. At the same time, what lies beneath that process, what root causes are there to be identified, we could work on, and what would happen if we improve those.
Okay, cool. What was the trigger actually to come up with this kind of reflection moment that you had now? So what triggered you to go into this thought world?
Yeah, I often wonder that myself, why did this happen? In this case, the direct trigger was business opportunity I heard of, and I was wondering, hey, is this something that would fit me, and would this be something I would like to contribute to? And in order to organize my thoughts, I start watching a pretty famous speech of Dr. Eckhoff, in which he talks about systemic improvements and about the differences between continuous improvement and discontinuous improvement, and also about building the right thing wrong and the wrong thing right.
Okay, so you had quite some thought period on this. So what would be your conclusions or both, or what would be in a two sentence summary your ideas related to the statements?
Yeah, so that will be the following, I'd say. Spend the time you have on contributing to making right things even more right.
Yeah, cool. So I guess this is the fun stuff to be. So trying to simplify in organizations, trying to make sure that we do the right things, but also for the right results. As we heard from Arnoud as well, if you have a good, very slim and simple process in place, then you will be able to validate if you're building the wrong things a lot faster than anything else, so that you can end up with building the right things the right way. Correct, Arnoud? Yeah, okay.
Could have said it better myself, Jurgen.
Okay, thanks for that. It was a pleasure having you around. If you want me or Arnoud to talk about other things, please leave something in the comments. For now, thanks, Arnoud. You've been a great support here. Bye.